Tonight, only charred rubble remains where a South Kingstown home once stood. And now we're learning more about what fueled the flames that sent a family of five to the hospital and destroyed everything they owned. Eyewitness News reporter Susan Campbell is live in South Kingstown now with the South County Mobile Newsroom.
Fire officials tell us a faulty extension cord is to blame for all of this damage. You can see a chimney is pretty much the only thing that's left of the Joneses' home. The tears, just like the rain that poured from the sky Monday morning, wouldn't let up.
I don't even know where to begin.
Kim Jones and her husband Mike have lived on Plains Road in South Kingstown for more than 20 years. It took flames less than an hour to destroy everything they owned.
What did you love about this house?
Everything. It was our home.
The fire started around 1:30 this morning. Mike smelled the smoke first.
My husband ran, yelled, "Everybody get up, get out of the house, there's a fire." And I ran downstairs and got the two little ones, and we all ran out the front door.
The whole family was safe, but mom, dad, and three kids, ages 12, 10, and 6, were all taken to the hospital to be evaluated. Fire officials tell us the fire was sparked by a faulty extension cord, then fueled by a large propane tank near the back of the house.
By the time we got out, to the time that walls started falling down, was, it seemed like an eternity to me, but it was probably 20, 25 minutes.
Now in the soot and debris, there's not much that's recognizable, but that didn't keep Kim from searching.
I found a few pictures and our chickens, which I can't even believe they made it through.
Small rays of hope among the ashes. There aren't any fire hydrants in this area, so firefighters had to wait for tanker trucks to bring in water to try to put out this fire. Coming up new at 6, hear about the outpouring of support for the family that used to live here. Live with the Mobile Newsroom, Susan Campbell, Eyewitness News.
Now we're working the latest developments on a massive early morning fire. The flames destroyed a family of five's home, leaving very little behind. New at 6, how the community is reaching out to help them begin to put the pieces of their lives back together. From the South County Mobile Newsroom, Eyewitness News reporter Susan Campbell is live in South Kingstown.
When the homeowners were here this morning, several people stopped by to offer them kind words and their support. We've also learned two fundraising pages have been set up online. At last check, people had donated about $3,000 to help the family that lived here. A home unrecognizable, leveled by intense flames.
Never in a million years would I think my house was going to burn down.
Kim and Mike Jones lived here on Plains Road in South Kingstown for two decades. This morning, fire tore through their home with a vengeance. Throughout the day, the Joneses' neighbors and extended family showed up quick to offer support.
Thanksgiving, Christmas, everything coming up, you know, it's just a terrible time. I don't know whether they had any Christmas gifts yet, but I mean, obviously everything's gone. We got a big family, so I'm sure there'll be a lot of help.
It's help they'll certainly need, since there were only a few things left to salvage.
I found a few pictures and our chickens, which I can't even believe they made it through.
Fire officials tell us the fire was caused by a faulty extension cord, then fueled by a large propane tank near the back of the house. To make matters worse, there aren't any fire hydrants in the area, and firefighters had to wait for tanker trucks to bring in water. Fire officials tell me two firefighters suffered minor injuries fighting this fire, but they are okay tonight. We also wanted to tell you we have put links to those fundraising pages on our website, WPRI.com. Live with the Mobile Newsroom, Susan Campbell, Eyewitness News.